Hi children, today you are going to learn 10th class, 3rd chapter, that is polynomials, exercise number 3.3. In that, we will be going to discuss about the relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. So already we have done a separate video on the relationship between zeros and coefficient of a polynomial. If you watch that video, then only you can understand this exercise 3.3. This exercise 3.3 complete depends on that video. Please watch that video, then come to this and watch this video. Then the video link also I'll keep in the description. You can go through that. And we'll go for the first bit. First question. We'll go for the first bit. First question. Then, here the first question is, find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial and verify the relation between the zeros and coefficient. We need to find out the zeros of the polynomial and also we have to verify those zeros with the coefficients. Okay, let us do it. First one, a polynomial P of x is equal to x square minus 2x plus, sorry, 2x minus 8, 2x minus 8. So let us find out the zeros of the polynomial. Already I told you, if you want to find out the zeros of the polynomial, let us make it this. If p of x is equal to 0, suppose if p of x is equal to 0, we will get 0 of the polynomial. So x square minus 2x minus 8 equal to 0. So let us split the middle term. As we know that how to split the middle term, x square into minus 8, that is minus 8 x square. X square into minus 8, minus 8 x square. This 8 can be written as 2 4s are 8, x into x, x square. Let us see here is the minus, where we have to put the minus. See, we have to put the minus here. Then 2x minus 4x is minus 2x. Plus into minus, minus, here it is plus. Plus into minus, minus, 2 4s are 8, x into x, x square. Then here 2x minus 4x is minus 2x, it is balanced. So we can write x square plus 2x minus 4x minus 8 equal to 0. In this, let us take out x as a common factor, then x plus 2 will be left over. In this definite, we have to take 4 as a common factor, then you will get x plus 2. That is equal to 0. Then overall, x plus 2 you take out common, then x minus 4 will be left, that is equal to 0. Then here, x plus 2 is equal to 0 and x minus 4 equal to 0. Where x equal to here minus 2 and x equal to plus 4. So these two are the zeros. Now let us check these zeros with the relation with the coefficients. It is not complicated, right? We have to check the relation with the coefficients also. Now how can we check the relation with the coefficients? As we have a formula, it is a quadratic polynomial. So if it is a quadratic polynomial, we will be having two zeros. One is alpha, the other one is beta. Then let us assume now. Let us take where alpha equal to minus 2 and beta equal to 4. Beta equal to 4. Alpha equal to, this we have to assume like alpha and this we have to assume like beta. Alpha beta equal to. So let us find out the sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros. That is alpha plus beta. Sum of the zeros equal to what you get here? Minus 2 plus 4 is equal to, minus 2 plus 4 is equal to plus 2. Then product of the zeros. Product of the zeros alpha beta equal to. Let us find out the product. Minus 2 into plus 4. Minus 2 into plus 4, that equal to minus 8. Now we got the zeros, sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. We also should check the relation between here sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. Let us check. So we'll know the now relation with the coefficient. Relationship with the coefficients. Let us find out here. sum of zeros alpha plus beta equal to formula is what, that is minus b by a minus b by a. That means this we have to compare with the general form of a. Now let me write r naught here. P of x equal to x square minus 2x minus 8. Let us compare with the general form of a quadratic polynomial, a x square plus bx plus c, where here a equal to 1, b equal to minus 2 and c equal to minus 8. Okay, let us find out now. Sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. No? Minus b by a, this is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, coefficient of x square. So alpha plus beta that equal to minus b by a equal to, what is the b value here? Minus b value is minus 2 by coefficient of x square, that is a value is 1. Here a value is 1. B value minus, according to formula we have to keep minus, and b value is minus 2, we have written here a value is 1. So let us write, this is minus of minus is placed, 2 by 1 will give us 2. Alpha plus beta equal to 2. The sum of the zeros you got 2, and the relation with the coefficient also you got a 2. Then we find out the product of the zeros. Product of the zeros alpha beta. Alpha beta equal to c by a. The c by c is nothing but a constant term by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. See, let us write alpha beta equal to c by a. That equal to constant term is what? That is constant term is minus 8. Coefficient of x square is 1. So we need to write. So we get here alpha beta equal to minus 8. See, now we got. See, what the question actually? Find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial. Yes, we got the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. One is alpha, then other one is beta, we assume. Then what we have done? That verify the relation between the zeros and coefficients. See, this zeros, the relation, when you add these two zeros, we got 2. Then we have multiplied these two zeros, the product of the zeros, we got minus 8. That means sum of the zeros from this quadratic polynomial, these two zeros we got it. When you do the sum of these two zeros, we got 2. And product of these two zeros, you got minus 8. When you check these with the relation of coefficients, with the relationship with the coefficient, these answers also we got same. Sum of the zeros 2 and product of the zeros minus 8. It is verified. It has to be verified in all the problems. Then only it will be correct. So okay, let us go for the next question now. Let's go for the next question. I'm not going to be up completely because the same steps will be going to be repeat here. Only numbers will be changed, the set. Relation with coefficient. Okay. Here numbers will be changes. So only the numbers I will change. The remaining all I keep it same. See. This will be relation with coefficient. Okay, let us write the second question of this page. That is P of S equal to, why I have written P of S? Because the polynomial is given in the terms of S. So 4S square minus 4S plus 1. So let us simplify this. If first of all we have to find out zeros of this quadratic polynomial, so we will make it this P of S equal to 0, then 4s square minus 4s plus 1 equal to 0. Let us split this middle terms. Let us see, 4s square into 1, that is 4s square. 4 can be written as here 2 2's are 4, s into s square, here minus and minus, we both we put the minus because we required minus 4 here, minus into minus plus 2 2's are 4, s into s square, minus 2s, minus 2s, minus 4s, it is balanced. So 4s square minus 2s, minus 2s plus 1 equal to 0. In this 2, we will take out 2s as a common factor in this 2 2's are 4. So 2s will be left, minus, here completely we took common, so minus 1 will be left. In this you have to take minus 1 as a common, then we will get the same as it is here. Then you took minus common, minus into minus. So minus into plus here. Minus 1 into 2s, minus 2s. Minus 1 into this 2s, minus 2s. Only this minus we took it common. The remaining term will be same here. Then here we need a plus, so you put minus here, minus into minus plus and 1. That equal to 0. So accordingly, similarly, this we have to get in this bracket. Accordingly, you have to take out common here. Then 2s minus 1. If you take out common, again 2s minus 1 will be left over, that equal to 0. If you make it equal to 0. Now here 2s minus 1 equal to 0 and 2s minus 1 equal to 0. Where 2s equal to 1, 2s equal to 1, s equal to 1 by 2 on both sides. Okay, here also s equal to 1 by 2 and there also s equal to 1 by 2. It has only 1 0. See, s equal to 1 by 2. Here also s equal to 1 by 2. It has same equal zeros. It has same equal 0. That means same 0. This quadratic equation having, this quadratic polynomial having only 1 0. 1 by 2. In before problem it has 2 zeros. As we discussed, a quadratic polynomial can have 2 zeros or 1 0 or no zeros also sometimes. Now let us take this is as a alpha and this we have to take as a beta. Then sum of the zeros. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. We know 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1. Half plus half will give us 1. Very easy. Then product of the zeros. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. That is 1 into 1, 1. 2 into 2 is 4. 1 by 4. We got it like that. So, by find out in zeros, when you find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial, we got alpha and beta. When you add this alpha and beta, we got sum of the zeros 1, product of the zeros 1 by 4. This 1 and 1 by 4, sum of the zeros 1 and product of the zeros 1 by 4, will we get when we change the relation with the coefficients or not? That is what we have to check. Yes, definitely we will get it. So let us check once. Here P of S equal to 4S square minus 4S plus 1. This is what our given quadratic polynomial in the terms of S. Then here when you compare with the coefficient, here A equal to 4, A value is 4. Then B value is minus 4 and C value is 1. Accordingly, A value 4, B value minus 4, C value 1, we have written. Why we have written? Because the coefficient relations will be like this. Where you do the sum of the zeros, half of this beta equal to minus B by A, where minus coefficient of X, minus B is nothing but minus coefficient of X by A is coefficient of X square. So let's minus B value is what here? Minus 4. By A value is what? 4. Do it here, minus into minus plus 4 by 4. 4 ones are, 4 ones are get cancelled, 1 will be left over. Where sum of the zeros we got 1, here also sum of the zeros 1. Balance. Now let's go for the next one. Product of the zeros C by A, where C is constant term and coefficient of X square. In this constant term is 1. By coefficient of X square, coefficient of X square it is A value, nothing but A value here, this is a 4. Simple. That is 1 by 4. See, the sum of the zeros, whatever you got here, here also the relation with the coefficient also we got the same one. Here with the product of the zeros, whatever you got, the same thing also we got it here. In this way we can check this. Okay. So, let me go for one more problem of this bit. One more problem I will solve it here. So remaining all will be same only. I hope you can do that all. I hope you can all do that. Let me go with that. Next one problem. Okay. Okay. The same thing we have to do it. Third problem. Here 6x square. P of x equal to 6x square minus. We write in the standard form. Minus 3 minus 7x is given. Okay, let me write this. See, we write in the standard form. P of x equal to first x square term, then minus x term, then constant term. This will be like this. So let us write. We'll make it. If P of x is equal to 0, then what happens? See, 6x square minus 7x minus 3 equal to 0. Let us split into the middle term. 6x square into minus 3, that is minus 18x square. 18 can be written as 2 9s are 18. X into x square. But here minus 7 will require, so minus will put here and plus will put here. 2 minus 7, 2 minus 7 is minus 7x. So it is balanced. 6x square plus 2x minus 9x minus 3 equal to 0. This minus 7x we can write in these two terms. So in these two we can take 2, we can take out common, because in two tables 6 will come and 2 will come. So x also we can take out common, 1x we have to take out. See, 2x we have completely taken, 2 3 is a 6 and 1x already we have to get common. 2x into 3x, 6x square. Plus this completely we took it common. Then here what we have to take out to get exactly 3x plus 1 as here. So simple, we have to take minus 3 as a common. Minus 3 into 3x, 9x. Minus 2 plus minus, 3 3 is a 9, into x, 9x. Here minus 2 plus minus, 3 1 is a 3. Is balance? No. Now you take 3x plus 1 as a common factor, so 2x minus 3 will be equal to 0. Then here you can do it. 3x plus 1 equal to 0, where here 3x equal to minus 1, x equal to minus 1 by 3. Yes? Then here 2x minus 3 equal to 0, where 2x equal to 3, x equal to 3 by 2. You got it here. Then let us take alpha equal to minus 1 by 3 and beta equal to 3 by 2. Beta equal to 3 by 2. Then sum of the zeros, minus 1 by 3 plus 3 by 2. Let us do the cross multiplication. 3 to the 6. 3 to the 6. 2 into minus 1, minus 2 plus 3, 3 is a 9. So what we are getting here, let us see. 2 9 minus 2, that is 7. 7 by 6 we got. Then product of the zeros here, minus 1 by 3 into 3 by 2. Minus 1 into 3. Here 3 3 get cancelled. Minus 1 by 2 will be left. Minus 1 by 2 will left. 3 and 3 will get cancelled. Minus 1 by 2 will left. And let us see if these answers will get it here or not. So we write our quadratic polynomial, that is 6x square minus 7x minus 3. When you compare with the ax square plus bx plus c, where a value like a 6, b value is minus 7, c value is minus 3. And we substitute in this now, alpha plus beta, here minus, b value is minus 7, a value is 6. Okay, minus into minus plus 7 by 6, we got the 7 by 6 here and there also. And let us check product of the 0, c by a, what is the c value here? Minus 3. Okay, minus 3, and a value is what? That is 6. 3 1s are 3 2s are, that equal to minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Sum of the zeros we got same, and the relation with the coefficient also we got the same. I hope you understood this completely. Okay. Let us go for fourth question. Our first bit. That is P of u equal to 4 u square plus 8 u. 8 u. Let's find out the zeros of the polynomial and relation with the coefficients. So if P of u equal to 0, then what happens? 4u square plus 8u equal to 0. In this itself, we can take out common. 4u you can take out common, see, here itself. Because there is no constant term. In before problem, there are constant terms. So we do not take out a direct common factor. Here we can take out directly common factor. Here 4 directly we took common, and 1 v 1 u we took common, 1 more u left, plus 4 2 times 8 and 1 u already we took out common. That means, it means that 4u equal to 0 and u plus 2 equal to 0. U plus 2 equal to 0. Then this 4 you transfer this side, u equal to 0 by 4 and where u equal to 0 and here u equal to plus 2 become a minus 3. Now let us take here alpha equal to 0 and beta equal to minus 2. Then sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros alpha plus beta is equal to sum of zeros. This u 2 you add it 0 plus minus 2. Nothing but 0 minus 2 is minus 2. Okay, directly write this minus 2. Now product of the zeros. Alpha beta equal to, let us multiply, 0 into minus 2 becomes 0 only. Now the relation between, relation with the coefficients. Relation with the coefficients. Okay, let us take this given polynomial. P of u equal to 4 u square plus 8 u. So let us compare this with the general form of polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, let us compare a value equal to 4, b value equal to 8 and c is a constant term. There is no constant term in the given polynomial. So it is 0. Now let us go for first here. Alpha plus beta equal to, what is the formula? Minus b by a. Minus b by a, this is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. This is important to write soon. Then alpha plus beta equal to minus b value is 8 by a value is 4. 4 was a 4 2s are, then alpha plus beta equal to minus 2. Here sum of the zeros by solving problem, by adding these two zeros, whatever we answer got, with the coefficient also we got the same answer. Then we go for next one, product of the zeros, alpha beta equal to c by a, that equal to constant term by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Constant term, that is alpha beta equal to constant term, that is 0. 0 by a equal to 4. 0 by something always 0. So alpha beta equal to also 0. What did you observe now? By adding with the coefficient also, by adding the zeros and with the coefficient relation also, we got a same answer. Okay. So next we go for the fifth question. It will be also same like this only. Let me solve that. I am going to build up only a few steps where it is going to be changes. Model, the process will be same only. See that t square minus 50. P of t equal to t square minus 15. See that t square minus 15. If p of t equal to 0, what happens? T square minus 15 equal to 0. This t minus 15 you transfer this side. T square equal to plus 15. The square you transfer there. When you square you are transferring, that become a square root. Root 15. Root 15. The t value, what is it? Root 15. Either you can do like this or not. We can also do in another way. See that how we are going to do it. This
15 is equal to 0, then t square minus, this I will write root 15 whole square, that equal to 0. This 15 I will write as a root 15 whole square. Why? Square and square, when you get cancel, again you get the same thing. There will be no change. Now here, it is in the form of a square minus b square, that equal to a plus b into a minus b. This formula can be used here. So, t plus root 15, we can write here, t minus root 15, we can write that equal to 0. As t plus root 15 is equal to 0, t minus root 15 equal to 0. Then t equal to minus root 15, t equal to plus root 15. This both are there. Yes? So directly also we get this. T square equal to 15. So t you transfer this, square you transfer, that means when square you are transferring, that is plus or minus root 15 will get it. So that means once plus root 15, then next minus root 15. Okay. Then here let us take alpha equal to minus root 15, beta equal to plus root 15. Alpha plus beta, that means minus root 15 plus root 15 equal to 0. Then alpha into beta, minus root 15 into plus root 15. Root 15 into root 15 minus under root of 15 into 15. Under root of 15 into 15 minus under root of 225, that's minus 200. Minus 225 value is 15, that is minus 15. So alpha beta equal to minus 15. Let us solve that in the same way here. P of t equal to t square minus 15. Here there is no t term, that means b value is 0. See, square value is there and constant value is there. Square is nothing but, here a value is nothing but here 1 t square. 1 x square, 1 t square. When you compare a value, you get 1. B value is 0 here, there is no B value. C value is minus 15. Then comparing this, minus B value or coefficient of X is nothing but, there is no X term. There is no coefficient of X term, nothing but B 0. B value is 0 by A value is 1. 0 by something always 0. So alpha plus beta value you got 0 here. Then alpha beta C by A. C value is what here? Minus 15. By a value is 1, minus 15 by 1, always will give us minus 15. We got the same answers. Once you observe this, if you want to take a screenshot, please take a screenshot of this. And we go for a next problem. Then the last problem, the sixth problem of this bit. Sorry. Yes, it was the fifth problem, sorry. Make it out, it is the fifth problem. We have completed the fifth problem. Now we go for the sixth one. Same again, same procedure. See, even you are able to do it, I am explaining everything. If anybody have a doubt, they can clarify the doubts here. Sixth one. P of x equal to, the given question is, 3x square minus x minus 4. 3x square minus x minus 4. So let us, if p of x is equal to 0, it become now 3x square minus x minus 4 equal to 0. Let us print the middle term here. 3x square into minus 4, that is minus 12x square. It can be written as 3 4s are 12. X into x, x square. So here minus x is required. If you put minus here, see, minus into plus minus 3 4 is 12, x into x, x square. But when you subtract this, 4x minus 3x is plus 1x, but here it is minus 1x. So this minus has to be keep it here. So concentrate where we have to put plus, where we have to put a minus, that we have to concentrate. So here we write this middle term, we can split like plus 3x minus 4x minus 4 equal to 0. In this two terms, 3x we can take out common here, only 1x plus here, 1 will be here, completely this took common. Here minus 4 if you take out common, we will get x plus 1 equal to 0. Where x plus 1 you take out common in this, 3x will be left here, minus 4 equal to 0. In that case, we get here, x plus 1 equal to 0, 3x minus 4 equal to 0. X equal to minus 1 here. Plus 1 we bring this side. Then 3x equal to 4. X equal to 4 by 3. So what is the alpha? Is minus 1. Beta is 4 by 3. Now let us add alpha plus beta. Minus 1 plus 4 by 3. This 1 we write as a 1 by 1. And we go for LCM. What we get? 1, 3 is a 3. 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. Plus 1, 4 is a 4. That equal to, please concentrate here. That equal to 4 minus 3 is 1 by 3. 1 by 3 we got it. That is alpha plus 0. Beta, sum of the zeros. Alpha, beta. Let us see alpha, beta. That is minus 1 into alpha. Alpha value minus 1. Beta value is 4 by 3. Minus 1 into 4, minus 4 by 3. Alpha, beta value minus 4 by 3. Let us see these 1 by 3 and minus 4 by 3. We get it alpha plus beta and alpha, beta value or not. In this way, we will get the same or not. Let us say the given P of x is 3x square minus 6 minus 4. When you compare to the general form, A value is 3, B value is minus 1, 1x here. Then C value is minus 4. Let us go for minus formula. In formula there is a minus, you put minus. B value is minus 1 by A value 3 minus B by A. Minus into minus plus 1 by 3. So we got 1 by 3 and here also we got 1 by 3. It is balanced. Now C by A. What is the C value? Minus 4 by A value is 3 minus 4 by 3. We got the same now. So in this way, we have completed this bit. If you have any kind of doubt, you can comment again. Please take a screenshot. Let me rub this now and we'll go through the next exercise, next bit. In the second bit, let's go for the second bit now. Second bit and third bit are important for 2 mark questions. Please concentrate in the second bit and third bit are important for 2 mark questions. See that in the second bit what they ask. Find the quadratic polynomial. Find the quadratic polynomial. They have to find the quadratic polynomial. In the introduction class, relation between the zeros and coefficients, I said how to form a quadratic polynomial. Okay. Find the quadratic polynomial in the case of given number of as sum and product of the zeros is given respectively. Sum and product of the zeros are given here in the second bit. Second bit, first one. See that one is 1 by 4, comma, next one is minus 1. What they are given? Sum of the zeros and product of the zeros are given in the question. Clearly understand. That means here they have given alpha plus beta equal to 1 by 4. Alpha beta equal to minus 1. Sum of the zeros. Alpha plus beta is given 1 by 4. Product of the zeros alpha beta equal to minus 1. They are not given alpha beta. They have given sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. So you have to take this. Now see that we have to write in the standard form of a quadratic polynomial. P of x equal to x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. This is standard form. In this way, it is up to that. Simple. So P of x equal to. So I told this is the standard form. You have to write like this. Please make it like this. That is the standard form, but you write k of x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. What is k in the sense? K is any constant number. K is any constant number there. Please mind it. Okay, k is any constant number. What is the use of this? I will tell you now. We write k here and we substitute x square minus alpha plus beta value, that is 1 by 4 into x plus alpha beta value is minus 1. Okay, let us simplify this. K of x square minus 1 into x is x by 4 plus into minus is minus 1. Okay, now see what is the k value. See, the quadratic polynomial should not be expressed like in a fractional form like this. To avoid this, this, what we have to do, we have to cancel the 4. If you cancel the 4, then you will get in a standard form of quadratic polynomial. So directly you cannot cancel. So what we have to do, this k will be help us now. So what is the denominator? You see here, the denominator is 4. So you assume k equal to 4. Now take, if k equal to 4, we have to substitute now, we have to take k equal to 4. Whatever the denominator there, that you assume like a k. If there is no denominator, you will leave it k equal to 1 only. Or not, directly you can see, directly you can eliminate the k. If there is no denominator, you got like this now. What you have to do? Just in the next step, k equal to 1. You put k equal to 1, directly you write the polynomial. That's enough. But we have denominator 4, yes. So you assume k equal to 4. Then what happens here? Just concentrate here. In the place of k, you put a 4 into x square minus x by 4 minus 1. Now you multiply with 4 to the all the terms. See, 4 into x square minus 4 into x by 4 minus 4 into 1. See, with this 4 I have multiplied these 3 terms. See, this 4 and this 4 will get cancelled. Now we will get in the standard form. P of x equal to 4 into x square, 4x square minus x minus 4 into 1 is minus 4. So this is a quadratic polynomial. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial, the quadratic polynomial equal to 4x square minus x minus 4. In this way, this k value will be useful here. If denominator is 3, then k equal to 3. Multiply with 3 to the other term. If denominator is 7, then k equal to 7. With 7, you multiply this one. That is what you have to do. With no denominator, you got started always. So if k equal to 1, then directly whatever there in the bracket, you write with that one. If you multiply with 1, or if you don't multiply with 1, you will get a same one. Next, we go for the for some more problems so that we can understand. Next problem is the second one. Root 2 comma 1 by 3. Root 2 comma 1 by 3. That means sum of the zeros alpha plus beta equal to root 2. Product of the zeros alpha beta equal to 1 by 3. Then what we need to do here? See, simple. Now let us substitute this in the standard form. What is the standard form of polynomial? P of x equal to k of x square minus alpha plus beta into alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Then here P of x k of alpha plus x square minus alpha plus beta value is root 2. Root 2 into x plus alpha beta value is 1 by 3. See that. What we are going to be doing? P of x equal to k of x square minus root 2 into x is root 2x plus 1 by 3. See, again we got a denominator 3. So if k equal to 3 now, if k equal to 3, you put like this. If k equal to 3, then what we have to do? P of x equal to 3 of x square minus root 2 into x plus 1 by 3. With this 3, we have to multiply this all. So P of x equal to 3 into x square minus 3 into root 2 into x plus 3 into 1 by 3. Here 3 and 3 get cancelled. Then you won't get any kind of a denominators here. 3 into x square, 3 x square minus 3 into root 2, 3 root 2 x plus, here 3 and 3 get cancelled, only 1 is left. Now this is our answer. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial, polynomial P of x is equal to 3x square minus 3 root 2x plus 1. This is what. So in this way we can do the solutions of first one and second one, and the remaining also we can do the same way. So let me solve that. Because the same formula we are going to use it now. So I am not going to be rub that formula. So you have to understand the process what I am going to do it here. Yes.
Now we go for question number 3.
That is 0, root 5. 0, root 5. So alpha plus beta 0. Alpha beta is root 5. Let us substitute in the standard form. K of x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Let us substitute in this. E of x equal to k of x square. Alpha plus beta value that is 0. So minus 0 into x plus alpha beta equal to root 5. See that what we are going to do. P of x equal to k of x square minus 0 into x is always is a 0. So we write 0 plus root 5. So what is the denominator? There is no denominator here. So if k equal to 1, you write k equal to 1, then P of x equal to 1 into x square. If there is a 0, there is no value. So we write only the number root 5. So with 1 you multiply, you get the same answer. So P of x equal to x square plus root 5. Therefore the quadratic polynomial P of x is equal to x square plus root 5. X square plus root 5. Then we go for the question number 4. That is 1 comma 1. 1 comma 1. Sum of the zeros is 1. Product of the zeros is 1. So let us substitute in this given polynomial. In the standard form of quadratic polynomial, that is x square minus alpha plus beta equal to 1 into x plus alpha beta equal to also 1. Then P of x equal to k of x square minus 1 into x is minus x plus 1. If k equal to 1, because there is no denominators here, we can find out. So P of x equal to 1 into x square minus x plus 1 and P of x equal to x square minus x plus 1. Therefore the quadratic polynomial P of x equal to x square minus x plus 1.
In this way we can complete this. So there are two more questions again. Let us solve that two more questions and we'll finish on this. Yes, we go for question number 5 here and question number 6 is here. Then question number 5 is minus 1 by 4 comma minus 1 by 4 comma plus 1 by 4. Okay, here alpha plus beta value is minus 1 by 4. Alpha beta value is plus 1 by 4. Let us solve this. P of x equal to k of x square root right constant. Alpha plus beta value is minus 1 by 4 into x. Alpha beta value is plus 1 by 4. Okay, should not worry and should not get scared that we have a fractional form numbers like this. If it is a fraction also, we do it the same procedure. X square minus into minus plus 1 into x is x by 4 plus 1 by 4. Same now. What is the denominator? K equal to 4. Here you will get a same numbers only. You will never get 3 here, here you will never get 4 like that. You will get same numbers always. If at all you get a different numbers, what you do? You have to take a LCM of this. You take a LCM. If it is 3 and 4 here, you take a LCM of this 3 and do it. Then overall you will get only one denominator, no? The K you have to assume that same. Simple. In that way you can complete. Then let's go for if K equal to 4. P of x equal to 4 into x square plus x by 4 plus 1 by 4. Now let us P of x equal to multiply with 4 into x square
plus 4 into x by 4 plus 4 into 1 by 4. 4, 4 get cancelled. Here also 4, 4 and get cancelled. So, p of x equal to 4 into x square, 4 x square plus here only 1 x is left plus here only 1 is left. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial equal to the quadratic polynomial p of x is equal to 4 x square plus x plus 1. Right, complete therefore.
And the sixth one is 4 comma 1.
Sum of the zeros is 4, product of the zeros is 1. Let us substitute here p of x equal to k of x square minus sum of the zeros is 4 into x, product of the zeros is only 1. Then p of x equal to k of x square minus 4 into x is 4x plus 1. Then if k equal to 1, because as there is no denominators here, we write p of x equal to 1 into x square minus 4x plus 1. Therefore, we get p of x equal to x square minus 4x plus 1. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial p of x is equal to x square minus 4x plus 1.
Qp is the same quadratic polynomial. I hope you understood this clearly. Now, if you want to take a screenshot, you please take a screenshot. And when sum of the zeros and product of the zeros are given, you have to do like this. Then the next bit is will be same like this, but we have to find out the sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. You have to understand that clearly. What we are going to do it in the next third bit. Third and fourth bit, only two more bits are left to complete this exercise. After completion of this exercise, we can go for next exercise.
Now, the third bit is that find the quadratic polynomial for the zeros alpha comma beta are given each case. Only the alpha comma beta are given in the each case. In before second bit, sum of the zeros, product of the zeros are given in each case. But here, only alpha and beta are given in the each case. Try to understand. So there will be only four questions in third bit. First question, that is 2 comma minus 1.
2 comma minus 1. Same procedure, but
two more steps will be increased here. Because here now they have given alpha equal to 2 and beta equal to minus 1. Alpha equal to 2 and beta equal to minus 1 they have given. So find out the sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros alpha plus beta equal to alpha the 2 plus sum of the zeros alpha plus beta 2 plus of minus 1 that equal to 2 plus into minus minus 1 2 minus 1 is 1 alpha plus beta equal to 1 then product of the zeros product of the zeros alpha beta equal to product of the zeros you multiply this 2 2 into minus 1 that equal to minus 2 alpha beta equal to minus 2. Now we have to substitute in the standard form. So simple. Now you got alpha plus beta, alpha beta. Now we can find out the quadratic polynomial. So now the quadratic polynomial will be p of x equal to k of x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. In the cubic polynomial standard form also we have to write k here. And the same procedure will be continuous. But there we will get sum of the zeros, sum and product of the zeros and product of the zeros. In the cubic polynomial. Okay. Now we will substitute the values. P of x equal to k of x square minus alpha plus beta that is 1 into x plus alpha beta values is minus 2. See the symbols, carefully you have to write the same number. P of x equal to k of x square minus 1 into x is minus x plus into minus is minus 2. If k equal to 1, so directly the next step, if k equal to 1, we get the same now. So p of x equal to x square minus x minus 2. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial p of x is equal to x square minus x minus 2. So see how simple they are, these problems are. These problems are very simple actually.
Next one, root 3 minus root 3.
Plus root 3 minus root 3. Plus root 3 and minus root 3. One is alpha equal to plus root 3 and beta equal to minus 2. Then we have to find out sum of the zeros. Alpha plus beta, you write like this. Directly you write sum of the zeros. Alpha plus beta. Root 3 plus here minus root 3. Of minus root 3. So here plus root 3. Plus into minus minus root 3. Plus root 3 minus root 3 get the answer that equal to 0. Alpha plus beta equal to we got 0. Then alpha beta product of the zeros multiply this root 3 into minus root 3 that equal to root 3 into minus root 3 equal to here plus into minus minus under root of 3 into 3 that equal to minus 3 into 3 is root 9. Root 9 value is 3 that equal to minus 3. Are not directly right? Plus into minus is minus. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. Like root A into root A. Root A into root A equal to A. Root 5 into root 5 is 5. Root 7 into root 7 is 7. Neither. You can directly write root 3 into root 3 is 3. But plus into minus is minus. So alpha beta equal to minus 3. Okay. Then what we have to do? We have to substitute in the standard form now. P of x equal to k of x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Yes. Now we substitute P of x equal to k of x square minus alpha plus beta value is what? 0. That into x plus alpha beta value is minus 3. So P of x equal to k of x square minus 0 into x is minus 0x. R not 0 minus 0 into x is 0 plus into minus is minus 3. Now there is no denominator. If k equal to 1, if k equal to 1, what happens? See, we write directly now P of x equal to here x square term. There is no 0 will not be value, so write we only write constant term. That is x square minus 3. Therefore, the quadratic polynomial P of x equal to x square minus 3. I hope you understood this. The next two will be also same like this, but do it by your own. The next two problems you do it by your own. Let's go for the fourth question of this exercise. Because I have done many problems on the standard form, only you have to find out sum of the zeros and product of the zeros and do it. Even those questions, if you are feeling difficult to solve, you can put your comment below. You have to try it. I have explained 6 or 7 problems based on the how to form a quadratic polynomial. So let's go for fourth one. Fourth question solution and the last question of this exercise. See that this last question is similar to example number 7 just before the problem. This question we are going to be explained here, fourth problem. This now this last question, the example number 7 is same to the last question. You can observe that both, you can write that also. See, verify 1 comma minus 1 and plus 3 are zeros of the cubic polynomial. First to verify this 1 minus 1 plus 3 are zeros of the cubic polynomial or not, and check the relation between zeros and coefficient. We have to check the relation with the zeros and coefficients. Okay, let us check. First of all, the given cubic polynomial, the given cubic polynomial P of x is equal to P of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square. X cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3. Okay, let us check this 1 minus 1 and plus 3. 1 minus 1 and 3.
These are the zeros of this cubic polynomial or not. Let us check. Let us put first, as we know, very simple it is how to check. So let us check at x equal to 1, in this polynomial we substitute, see, p of x equal to, that means directly p of 1 I will do it. P of 1 is equal to here, let us take p of 1, okay, then let me do it directly here, like this. At x equal to 1, so p of 1 equal to 1 cube minus 3 into 1 square minus x value 1 plus 3. Then p of 1 equal to 1 cube value 1 minus 3 into 1 square value 1, 3 into 1 is 3, minus 1 plus 3. Here plus 3 minus 3, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. P of 1 equal to 0. P of 1 equal to 0, you got it. Now at x equal to minus 1, we will check it at x equal to minus 1. That means here p of minus 1 equal to x cube minus 1 whole cube minus 3 into x square minus 1 x square minus 1 whole square minus of x value minus 1 plus 3. Wherever the x present, you put the minus 1. Simple. And we solve it. P of minus 1 equal to minus 1 whole cube. If power is 3, it is a odd number of terms. So we get minus 1 as the answer. Now minus here. Here square. Minus 3 into 1 square value is 1. Minus into minus plus 1 plus 3. Check here. Minus 3 into 1 is 3 only. Minus 3 into 1 is 3. Directly I get. This is minus 1 square is plus 1. So minus 3 into 1 is 3. So let me do it. Minus 3 plus 3. Minus 1 plus 1. Cancel. So P of minus 1 equal to also we got 0. Okay. Then at x equal to 3. X equal to plus 3 is here. Plus 3 or 3. Both are same one. So P of 3 equal to wherever the x present in this polynomial, you put the 3. 3 cube minus 3 into x square, then you got 3 square minus x value 3 plus 3. Here it is simple. Now see that P of 3 equal to 3 cube is 27. 3 into 3 into 3 27 minus 3 into 3 square value is 9. Here minus 3 and plus 3 both are get cancelled. Now see that P of 3 equal to here 27 minus 3 9s are 27. This both also will get cancelled. P of 3 equal to also we got 0. Then therefore we can write 1, minus 1 and 3 are zeros of this cubic polynomial, because when you substitute 1, minus 1, 3 in this given cubic polynomial, we are getting zeros. So they are zeros of the cubic polynomial. Therefore 1, comma, minus 1 and less 3 are zeros of the given cubic polynomial. Given cubic polynomial. Next, they are given cubic polynomial. Now we have to check the relation with the coefficients. Now let us check the relation with coefficients. Relation with the coefficients. Relation with the coefficients. So as we have minus 1, minus 1 and 3. 1, 0 we have to assume like alpha equal to 1, beta equal to minus 1 and gamma equal to 3. There are 3 zeros of this given polynomial, no? This given cubic polynomial. So a cubic polynomial will be having 3 zeros. One is alpha, next one is beta, and the next one is gamma. Alpha, beta, gamma. So let us check it. The relation, first relation let us check it. Alpha plus beta plus gamma. Alpha plus beta plus gamma. So that equal to, actually alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to what you get, say, let us see. 1 here plus beta value is minus 1, gamma value is 3. So plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, that equal to 3. Alpha, beta, gamma value you got 3. sum of the zeros alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to what 3, then this will check with the relation with the coefficients. Now itself will check it, one by one will check it here itself. So what is alpha plus beta plus gamma? Formula actually minus b by a, nothing but minus coefficient of x square by coefficient of x cube, coefficient of x square. Let us see here, alpha plus beta plus gamma, okay, equal to minus, we put the minus here, coefficient of x square. Let us put coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is what? Minus 3. In this only we have to see. Are not you write this polynomial here? P of x equal to x cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3, and compare with the general form of cubic polynomial ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. A value will get like a 1, and b value is minus 3, and c value is minus 1, and d value is 3. With this also you can complete how we have done in the first bit. Same. So minus, we have got the minus. B value is what? Minus 3. R not coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is what? Minus 3. So minus of minus 3 by coefficient of x cube, that is 1. R A value is 1. That equal to minus into minus plus 3 by 1 value is 3. So we got the same now. The relation with the zeros, the sum of the zeros as given 3, the relation with the coefficient of minus b by a minus coefficient dot x square by coefficient dot x cube also given 3. Next, what sum and product of the zeros? Sum and product of the zeros. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to, let us do it, alpha into beta, 1 into, see slowly, 1 into minus 1, okay, this you put in a bracket, plus, are not given like that, okay, then beta into gamma, beta into gamma, minus 1 into 3, this will be in the bracket, plus gamma into alpha, 3 into 1, so in this way we have to multiply, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, plus minus 1 into 3, it is minus 3, minus 3, plus into minus is minus, so it is minus 3 now, 3 into 1 is 3, here plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled, we get alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to minus 1, here we got a minus 1. See, now this we check with the relation with the coefficient, what is the product of the zeros, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus sum and product of the zeros, gamma alpha, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a is the formula. What is the c here? Coefficient of x by coefficient of a is nothing but coefficient of x cube. So let us find out alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c value. C in the sense coefficient of x. Coefficient of x is minus 1. Nothing but c value is minus 1. By a value is also 1. Coefficient of x cube. Nothing but we get here completely minus 1. See? Here sum and product of the zeros we got minus 1. By the coefficient relation also we got minus 1. In that way we get. Then next one. The third one, product of the zeros alpha into beta into gamma, alpha into beta into gamma, let us multiply, 1 into minus 1 into 3, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 into 3 is minus 3, we got it. Then this we check with the relation with the coefficient, alpha beta gamma equal to minus d by a, minus d, minus d in the sense here, constant term, by coefficient of x cube. So alpha beta gamma equal to minus constant term. Constant term is 3. Nothing but d value is 3 here. So let us put minus 3 by a value is 1. That in the sense here minus 3 by 1 is nothing but minus 3. Again you got a same here. Alpha, beta, gamma value minus 3, and here also the relation with the coefficient also we got same answer, that is minus 3. I hope you understood this problem. You can also compare with the example number 7 before the exercise number 3.3. Both are similar, just same model questions are there. Okay, and here you need to be understand. Suppose, see here one thing we'll do it now. See this polynomial, you remember this. Now let us find out this polynomial in the standard form. This is not asked the question actually. This is an extra information for you. For example, let us see. They have given three zeros. Suppose like a second bit or third bit. Suppose like a second and third bit, if they ask the question, how to do it? Suppose they have given three zeros, 1 comma minus 1 comma 3. Find out the cubic polynomial. Find the cubic polynomial. How will you find out? This is alpha and this is beta is minus 1 and gamma equal to 3. Then find out sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma. Sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma, if you do it, 1 minus 1 plus 3. So you will get a 3. Alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to 3. Then alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to what you get? Then you multiply that all. Already we have multiplied, no? That is minus 1 we got it. Yes. Alpha beta gamma equal to what you got it? Minus 3. Then you multiply. Only if they are given 3 zeros and ask you to find out the cubic polynomial. How to find it? This 3 we need to find. Then standard form. The standard form of cubic polynomial we have to write. K of x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma into x square plus alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha into x minus alpha beta gamma. In this, if you are substituting this, then you will get it. Directly cubic polynomial. Let us check. P of x equal to k of x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to 3. 3 into x square, 3 x square plus alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to minus 1. Minus 1 into x is minus x minus alpha beta gamma. Alpha beta gamma value is minus 3. So minus of minus 3 is plus 3. Simple. Now if k equal to 1, directly you will get p of x equal to x cube minus 3x square minus x plus 3. You got the cubic polynomial. See, if they are given zeros, we can find out the cubic polynomial also. If they are given cubic polynomial, we can also find out the zeros. That we will learn in the next exercise. See, if they are given zeros, we will find out the sum of the zeros, sum and product of the zeros and product of the zeros. By using that, in the standard form formula, we will get cubic polynomial. If they are given directly this, sum of the zeros, sum of 3 zeros in a cubic polynomial is 3. And sum and the product of the zeros is minus 1. And product of the zeros is 3. Then directly if they have given these values, you substitute in this and find it. Okay, that you have to think. Either they have given a zeros individually or not sum of the zeros and product of the zeros are given. That what they have given, accordingly we have to substitute in the standard form. So I hope you understood this exercise clearly. Keep practicing and keep get knowledge. Thank you.